If we want to be able to calculate angular momentum, which we do want to do because it helps us with a lot of physics problems, we first need to calculate moment of inertia. And moment of inertia is going to depend on the shape we're using. After all, a single point sitting at the center is different than a single point far away, which is different than a filled-in disk. So as a result, we're going to need a set of equations. So first, let's try to understand these equations a little bit. Position doesn't matter to angular momentum, other than how far away you are. So a single object of mass m, a distance l away, or two on opposite sides, each of which are m over 2, that's going to give you the exact same result, because it's the same total mass, m, and all of it's the same distance away, l. So you could extend that even further. You could say, let's have a disk that's hollowed out, so there's just mass on the very edge, and it's mass m, and every part of its distance l away from the center. Once again, our moment of inertia I is ml squared. So that's fairly simple. But what about a more complicated scenario? Let's say you have a filled-in disk, so the entire disk is solid. No longer can we say that everything is a distance l away from the center. Some stuff is distance half l or two-thirds l all over the place. So we need a different way to look at it. And if you wanted to do this yourself, you can use calculus to integrate across the radius of the disk. And if you know how to do this, I'd invite you to try it, see what you get. But for the rest of us, we're just going to go the easy way, and we're going to use a table of equations. And this is the table of equations for common different shapes. And it's possible that there's different. It's possible you'll encounter stuff that isn't on this table. But the thing is, when you do that, you can almost always approximate it as a combination of the two. And I'll show you how to do that later. But for now, let's look over this very quickly. A solid cylinder or a solid disk, they're the same thing. It's how long it is doesn't actually matter. And in this case, it's 1/2 mr squared. And the reason for that is because some of the mass is located in between. It's not all on the edge or at the center. So as a result, it's not going to be as big as mr squared as it would be for a Hooper on the symmetry axis. But it's also not zero. It's in between. And around the symmetry axis just means rotating around its center, whereas central diameter means that the axis is actually going down through the center. So if this is the side of the sphere, the axis is going up and down like that. So using these standard equations, you could really do quite a lot. They give you most of the stuff you need. And if you need a different example that's not here, you can almost always look it up. Now the one other thing we need to understand is sometimes you need to use combinations. For instance, what happens if you have a spinning disk and then you drop a rock onto it? How do you think of that? Well, you can use the equation for the spinning disk to describe the spinning disk. Right? It has a radius r, a mass m, and that's easy enough. And then the rock is small enough, you can treat it as a point. You can say it has a radius r2 and a mass m2. So then when we solve it out, the moment of inertia is just going to be m2 r2 squared, and that's for the rock, and then plus 1/2 mr squared. And that's the disk. And because they're each independent from each other, we can just add them up. They don't interact at all strangely. So this is really easy. If you need to combine different moments of inertia, you can just separate the parts out and add them together. So in this case, we separate out a disk around an axis and a rock that's rotating a distance away from the axis, but around the same axis. So as long as the axis is the same, you can just do simple addition. So this is one of the key points for this lecture. And now that we understand this, we're finally ready to move on to angular momentum and understand how that works and how we can calculate stuff based on that.